So for the last few classes, we were discussing the first order circuits. And in the first order circuit, we discussed the RC circuit and RL circuit. We started our discussion from natural response and then moved to forced response. And when we discussed the forced response, I have introduced the singularity functions. And here we discussed the step response. So step response of RC circuit, we have already seen. Now in today's lecture, we'll focus on step response of RL circuit. So the discussion will be quite similar to what we have discussed for the RC circuit. So let us see the RL circuit. So we have one RL circuit. So that is a first order circuit because we have one energy storage element and a DC source is there, which is VS, which is connected to the circuit at time t equal to zero using a switch. So initially the switch was opened, but after this time t equal to zero, the switch is closed. And when the switch is closed, the DC source is directly energizing the circuit, which consists of a resistor and the inductor. So to show the switching action and the application of the DC voltage, we have introduced the step voltage, that is U of t. Then the DC voltage will be multiplied Vs with U of t. What is the reason? Because for all time t greater than zero, when the excitation has taken place by switching the circuit, then the magnitude is constant and that is equal to Vs. So this is for all time t greater than zero. Time t less than zero, there was no magnitude and the DC voltage was off from the circuit. So that is the reason to show the transient condition. We have introduced the step voltage U of t. Now, once the switch is closed, the resistor and inductor will come in series and there will be a flow of current in the network. So when we say that step response, response means the output. So we try to learn like what will happen when the switch will close in terms of the current and the voltage. So if we apply the KVL equation in this circuit, so what we are going to get? So KVL equation, when we apply, that is the Kirchhoff's voltage law. So the voltage drop in the resistor VR is equal to I into R. And the voltage drop in the inductor VL is equal to L di by dt, that we know, is equal to the supply voltage, which is equal to Vs U of t. Now we are interested in studying the response of the circuit for time t greater than zero, because there is a step response in the circuit, step source in the circuit rather. So we say the KVL equation is I into R plus L di by dt is equal to Vs, where Vs is the DC source that is applied in the circuit for time t greater than zero. Now, if we separate the variables and rewrite the equation, so we can form in the LHS side L di by Vs minus Ri, and on the right hand side, we will have dt. Now, this equation can be integrated to find the solution. So on integrating, we will get the equation in this manner, where we will have one constant of proportionality, that is A, and we need to determine the value of A using the boundary condition. So we know that inductor do not allow a sudden change in the current and capacitor do not allow a sudden change in the voltage. So we are dealing with the inductor. So current at time t 0 minus is equal to current at time t 0 plus, which was equal to zero because the inductor was initially uncharged. So there was no current initially for the inductor. Hence the current for all time t less than zero minus, that is the momentary amount of time less than zero minus and zero plus, will be equal, and that is equal to zero. So in this equation, if we put t equal to zero, then we can find out what is the constant A value. So constant A is equal to minus L by R ln of Vs. Now, once we have got the constant, we can put it the value of the constant in the equation, that is the solution. And further simplification we can do to write the equation in a better way. So the final solution, that is the complete solution, if you want to write for all time t, then we can write the current is equal to Vs by R 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau into u of t, where the time constant tau is equal to L by R of the circuit. We have already discussed the time constant, that is when the time taken for the circuit to reach 36.8% of the maximum amount of the voltage or the current. Now, these equation of the inductor current, which is Vs by R 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau, can be plotted when we have the initial current as I naught. So, in this equation, we have assumed that the current I naught initially is zero. However, if we take the current I naught into account, that is, the inductor is initially having a current or value I naught, then the total amount of the current equation for all time t greater than zero, that is u of t, can be written as I naught plus Vs by R1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. If we plot this equation in terms of a graph for the time with respect to the current, then we see that this started from the initial current, which is I naught, and then it is exponentially decaying till a value of Vs by R. So this is the current graph for the first order RL circuit. Now, if we want to find out the voltage, once we have known what is the current, we can find out the voltage. So you know that the voltage in the inductor is equal to L times di by dt. So we have already found out the current equation. So we can differentiate the current with respect to time. So our current equation is I of t is equal to Vs by R 1 minus e to the power t by tau u of t, considering that I naught is equal to 0. So this is the assumption that we will do, that the initial current in the inductor is 0. Then if we differentiate the current to get the voltage, we get V of t is equal to L di by dt. Now differentiate the current equation and put it here with an assumption that, or the time constant substitution as tau equal to L by R. Finally, we'll get a solution for V of t is equal to Vs, that is the DC voltage, e to the power minus t by tau into u of t to represent that it is a step response. So this is the voltage equation and this is the current equation for a RL circuit. So when we have a first order RL circuit, the current and voltage equation we have derived. Now, if we draw the curve for both voltage as well as the current. So first, we let us draw the current graph, considering that the initial current I naught is equal to zero. We get a current increasing graph, that is, the inductor is charging to the supply, that is Vs. So the maximum amount of charging will be equal to Vs by R. Whereas if we draw the voltage curve, we will see that the voltage will be exponentially decaying from the initial amount of Vs in the circuit. Now, we have already discussed that whenever there is a transient phenomena occurring in the circuit, then the transient will die out after a time of 5 time constant. So whenever there is 5 time constant time interval, then the transient phenomena dies out, whether it is a charging phenomena or whether it is a discharging phenomena. So here, if we see the current which is charging the inductor, or the inductor is storing the energy, then at a time of 5 time constant, 5 tau, the inductor is fully charged for a value of E by R, or we can say Vs by R, that is the net amount of DC voltage divided by the resistance present in the circuit. Similarly, if we draw the voltage curve for the inductor, we see that for a time constant 5 tau, or the time of 5 tau, the voltage present in the circuit has reduced to less than 1%. So we say that 5 time constant or 5 tau is the amount of the time that is required for either the circuit to be fully charged or the circuit to be fully discharged, or rather the transient die out and the circuit reach to the steady state. Now, having known the concept, we'll see the problem solving steps for the RL circuit. So the general solution for the current I of t is equal to I infinity, which is the steady state, plus I naught, that is the initial value of the current in the inductor, minus I infinity e to the power minus t by tau, where the value of tau is L by R. Then if the time delay has taken place in opening the switch or closing the switch, then the time which is 0 will be replaced with t naught in the circuit, and here the time t will be replaced with t minus t naught. So these are the general solution which can be used to obtain the current in the circuit. So with this general form, we can see that the steps required to obtain the final solution is, the first step is obtain the initial inductor current. So we need to obtain the initial inductor current I naught at time t equal to 0. If the circuit has been switched at t naught, so we need to obtain at I t naught, where t is equal to t naught is the switching instant. The next step is determine the final inductor current, that is I infinity, which is the steady state current in the circuit. And the third step, which is the final step, is to obtain the value of time constant. So time constant is equal to L by R, where the R value is equal to R Thevenin in the circuit when the inductor is replaced, and at its terminals we will obtain the value of R Thevenin. So let us see the problem. So this is the circuit that we are going to deal. Find the current I of t for time t greater than 0. Assuming the switch has been closed for a long time. So what was the initial circuit? So if we draw the initial circuit, we have a 10 volt source, and then we have a 2 ohms resistor, 3 ohm resistor, and then we have an inductor. So this is 2 ohms, this is 3 ohms, and the switch was closed for a long duration of time, and then it is opened at t equal to 0. So this is for all time t less than 0, and this circuit is for all time t greater than 0. So first we know that we need to find the initial current which is present in the inductor. So I of 0 is equal to I of 0 minus is equal to I of 0 plus, since we know that inductor do not allow a sudden change in the current. So before the switching and after the switching, what is the current present in the inductor? That will be the initial current in the inductor. So let us see for time t less than 0, what will be the current flowing in the inductor, or the current present in the inductor. Since the switch was closed and it creates a short circuit in the circuit, so the 3 ohm resistor will be short circuited, and the current flowing in the circuit I will be equal to the total voltage, that is 10 volt, divided by the total amount of resistance, that is equal to 2 ohms, because 3 ohm resistor will be short circuited by the switch. Then the current that is flowing in the network is 5 volt, because you know that for long duration of time the inductor will be short circuited for the DC source, that is the steady state condition of the inductor. So for a long duration of time when the switch was closed, then at an interval of t less than 0, slight 0 minus I can say, at that time the inductor will be short circuited. Since the switch is closed, the 3 ohm resistor will be short circuited, and the current will be equal to 10 volt by 2 ohms, that is equal to 5 ampere. So the current of 5 ampere is the current which is stored in the inductor at time t 0 minus or 0 plus, because the inductor will not allow a sudden change in the current. Now what is the amount of the current when the switch is open at time t equal to 0 and the switching action has taken place, and after that what will happen? So when the switch is opened, the 2 ohm resistor and 3 ohm resistor will be coming in series, because earlier the 3 ohm resistor was not present. Now it will be present because of opening of the switch. And the inductor again at time t equal to infinity, that is the steady state, again it will be short circuited. So if it is short circuited, the current flowing in the network is equal to the total voltage, that is 10 volt, divided by the sum of the resistance, which is equal to R equivalent in the network, which gives to be 2 ampere. That is the current that is flowing in the circuit for I infinity. Now the third case is to obtain the R Thevenin at the inductor terminal. So if this is the inductor terminal that we have, if we open circuit the inductor terminal and then we see what is the total resistance that is the RThevenin in the circuit, creating the short circuit for the voltage source, then we find that the RThevenin is equal to the sum of the two resistance, because our network will be 2 ohms and 3 ohm coming in the circuit. So we have 2 ohms and 3 ohms which are coming in series, and that will give the RThevenin as equal to 5 ohms. Now we have got the initial current, we have got the I infinity, that is the steady state, and we have also got the value of RThevenin. So we can determine the value of tau, which is the time constant. Time constant is equal to L by R, where R is the RThevenin in the network. So L value is 1 by 3 and RThevenin is 5 ohms. So we get the time constant is equal to 1 by 15 second. Now we can put it in the general equation form to get the final solution. So the current I of t is equal to I infinity, which is the steady state. The steady state is the 2 amps, so we have put 2 amps here. The initial current I naught that we have got is 5 ampere, so we can put it 5 ampere. The steady state current is again 2, and we have e to the power minus t by tau, where tau is the time constant. So if we substitute the time constant as 1 by 15 second, the final equation that we get is equal to 2 plus 3 e to the power minus 15 t. ampere. So this is the equation of the current for all time t greater than 0. So we can write this is multiplied with u of t to replace this time from the circuit equation. So this is the equation which we need to determine, find I of t for time t greater than 0. So this is the solution of this particular problem. So we have completed our discussion of first order circuit, and we will revise the formula first to understand what we have discussed entirely in the first order circuit. So we have started our discussion from RC circuit, and then we moved to RL circuit. First we have discussed the natural response, and then we moved to forced response. So the natural response is the response which is independent of the external excitation. So the initial voltage that is present in the circuit is V naught, which is responsible for driving the circuit, and the equation of the voltage V of t is equal to V naught e to the power minus t by tau. Whenever we are talking for the RC circuit, the time constant tau will be equal to RC, and the resistor current is equal to V voltage by resistance, so it is equal to V naught by R e to the power minus t by tau. So these two equations will be required when we are dealing with the natural response of RC circuit having initial voltage V naught in the capacitor. Now when we talk about the forced response, then the voltage and the current equation for all time t greater than 0, when we have the step voltage u of t, then we can write the voltage equation as Vs. Now here we have the DC voltage as Vs, which is applied in the circuit, that is the forced excitation. So voltage is equal to Vs 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau, and the current is equal to Vs by R e to the power minus t by tau. So if we observe this equation of natural response and forced response, they are quite similar in nature, except that the initial voltage is V naught in the circuit, and there is a forced response or excitation of Vs, DC voltage step input in the circuit. Then the complete response will be the sum of the natural response plus the forced response for the RC circuit. If we study for the RL circuit, so the time constant will be L by R in this case, and the natural response will have initial inductor current I naught, which will drive the circuit. That will have a current IT is equal to I naught e to the power minus t by tau, and the resistor voltage is equal to I into R, which is equal to I naught R e to the power minus t by tau. Whereas if we have the forced response, that is Vs, that is the DC voltage which is applied for as a step input, then the current and the voltage equation for the RL circuit will be Vs by R 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau into the step response, that is u of t step input, and the voltage V of t is equal to Vs e to the power minus t by tau u of t. If you observe these two equations, they have interchanged their positions and the equations remains the same. So you can see that the current, which was Vs by R e to the power minus t by tau, has now reduced from 1 minus, because this is an RL circuit. So we can replace this side and we can replace this side to remember the formula of the RC circuit and the RL circuit, that is the sum of natural response plus forced response. So the three steps that we have discussed, the general solution, second step is to find the initial and the final current and to determine the time constant by determining the Thevenin resistance. If you determine all these three quantities properly, you will be able to solve any problem related to first order circuit.